And Mariah's eating for two because, you know.
Yeah, right? We got some news for you guys.
Right?
Just things, you know, we'll just be open with you guys, let you guys know.
Guys, I am so sad because this is like a huge step and I know a lot of you are ready and waiting for
it. No, you guys ask this questions all the time.
We're going to get deep into this,
guys. We are going to get deep into it. Deep, deep, like really. Alright guys, so I know you guys did not click on this video for this exact reason, but I'm about to tell Bill. He's walking out right now. I'm about to tell him that we lost our house and get his reaction. Okay guys, he's coming in, he's coming in. Okay, we're going. I'm gonna locate them.
This is only $28.
For all of this?
Yeah, that's it.
That's crazy. So I have some news to tell you.
Huh?
So you know how I just texted our realtor and stuff and I asked him like if we could move in before May 28th?
Yeah.
He told us
that we can move in?
No, he said that there was issues with the house and we can't move into the house.
No.
Yeah, I'm not lying, baby. I'm not lying.
You're lying.
No, I'm not.
You'd be crying right now if that was true.
Okay.
Why are you smiling?
I'm not smiling.
Show me the message then.
I was trying to film. Okay, so I was sitting here thinking of something that I can mess with you with so bad.
You don't mess around with
you start
with
walking
house.
Out right when I'm filming an intro. I'm like, shoot, I gotta hurry up and do it.
You don't mess around with
guys,
us getting a house.
Listen, I didn't want to do that prank for long. It's not, I don't think that's a funny prank because we are so excited. We've been so anxious. I had to do a little prank on you today, okay? Just
a little bit.
But we least expect
Stop. Guys, so we just picked up food. Look at this bag.
Guys.
That was only $28 worth of stuff.
And let me just say, I'm not even going to tell you guys what it looks like, but this is the best Mexican food ever.
It's
like,
so good.
I can't even tell you, like, this is real. Like, it's not like.
We got it, like, legit. It's oh, not, it's no God. Copycat. This stuff is legit. And Mariah's eating for two because, you know, little baby on the inside.
Yeah,
right?
We got some news for you guys.
Right?
But.
Hit. Guys, we're going to talk about it in a little bit. Stay tuned because we have a lot of news to discuss with you guys.
And just things, you know, we'll just be open with you guys, let you guys know, you know, some things that have been going on and, you know, yeah. Eating for two today.
Guys, just get ready. Guys, I am so sad. Literally, like,
why?
Because we literally bought a TV and it's, I feel like it's just too small.
It is too small.
Okay, so we were buying a TV from Best Buy for our house that we're supposed to be moving into and it came in and this thing is just tiny. Right?
Yeah.
I think we need to return it.
I think
even
so.
We already opened the box though.
Yeah,
should we show them?
I'm really embarrassed.
Like, look at, I know. Don't make fun of it, guys. The TV, can you stand next to it? It's just too small,
it's
I think.
It's like really tiny.
It is. Like 70, I'm just kidding, guys. This TV's freaking massive.
Guys, you guys have no idea. It's from like here all the way to here. You got, it's huge. We actually took it out.
Lay next to it. I want to see you. Look at it compared to Mariah. This is how big it is.
It's still not even like.
It's taller. Okay, it's taller than her. She has her arms out, but look at it. It's a 75 inch. Nice. We literally bought this, and I was telling Mariah, I think we should get an 85 inch. And she's like, we don't need an 85
inch. We do not need an 85 inch. And we literally took this out when Meg and Jordan were here. We were playing Mario Kart, and it was so big. And it was so
like,
nice.
It was like a normal TV, but times four. Like each split screen was like a TV in itself.
It was awesome.
I can't wait for you to see this on our house wall.
Guys, stay tuned. We're so excited.
Oh my God.
We're so excited.
We're so close to moving in. I could taste it.
I could taste it too. We're about to go eat.
Do I know what else I can taste?
The food.
The food. Mariah wanted a reveal. Oh wait, you can't do it that fast.
What?
It has to be literally like planned out and beautiful, babe. Come on. Mariah wanted to, before we started talking about pregnancy and birth control and stuff, she wanted to do a quick reveal. Cue the sexy, awesome, revealing music. Oh my gosh.
And Bill.
And then I got some fajitas. Ready for this? This is what I'm talking about. This is a good lunch. This is like a dinner.
Salsa, guys.
But look at how good this looks,
guys. This taco place is smacks.
So we just filmed the video in this exact spot. We just posted it. It was the twin telepathy video. That video was crazy because we did a part two to her and her twin sister.
We did so many things and just sit here. We went outside. We did a bunch of things. Make sure you guys go check that video out.
And the fact that they got so many of them right just makes me believe in telepathy. I want to see. Here, wait. Do we have telepathy? Hold on. Raise up a hand. It could be a random hand. Ready, set, go. We don't have telepathy.
No, we don't got that connection.
But her twin sister, I think, has telepathy because you guys got things right that were just
insane.
Blew my mind.
Literally. But guys, today we have never actually done a mukbang before, or mukbang, however you say it. But for some reason, people just really enjoy watching you eat and talk about things. So today we're going to be talking about birth control. Have I stopped taking birth control? Why did I stop taking birth control? Am I still taking birth control? All the questions you guys are asking, or are we looking to have kids? Or are we pregnant?
Or have we already started trying?
Yes. And we're going to... I don't know. Do you want to tell them?
We're going to get deep into this,
guys. We are going to get deep into it, guys. And we're going to let you guys know...
We're going to get deep, deep into this.
Deep, deep. Like, real deep.
You get it?
Mm-hmm. I get it.
Okay, ew. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up right now and comment down below how you think after you hear all this and what our plan is in life, because this is like a huge step and I know a lot of you are ready and waiting for
it. No, you guys ask these questions all the time. You guys are always wondering what's going on.
Here, how about you get into it then?
So let me just start off with one thing. Who eats lime or puts lime on their tacos? You do not, I'm telling you, it's game changer and it's ooh.
That's a fact. No, make sure to do that. But I was talking more about the video.
Oh, okay.
More about the baby. Finger. No. Ew, I don't know where those fingers have been. Ooh. Did you even wash your hands? Did you even wash your hands before you ate?
No.
Disgusting.
Yes, I did.
How are you ready to have a baby?
Yes, I did.
You're
wash
gonna need
my
to be
hands.
Sanitary.
Why would I not wash my hands?
Our kids are gonna be the messiest kids if you don't start taking care of yourself now.
Whatever. Okay, so we're gonna start off right into this video. So I started taking birth control when I was a sophomore or junior in high school. I honestly don't remember, but
why did you start taking it though?
So I started taking it, because I'm gonna be honest, with my ex. I was sexually active and my periods were also kind of irregular.
You gotta warn me if you're gonna start talking about your ex.
Sorry, I'm just being honest. All right, we're done. But my mom and dad just really wanted me to get on birth control just so I didn't get pregnant. And honestly, it was a really smart move just because I felt safer and I wasn't at the time of my life where I could accidentally have a kid. Like, I just wasn't ready for that.
If you had a kid, we wouldn't be together probably.
I know.
Ex's kid.
Yeah.
Which I would not want to do.
But I started taking it because I would rather have consistent periods. So I started taking it. And I had one medicine, and this gets really deep. So me and my twin were actually taking the same pills, the same dosage. I think it was like, I don't even remember how it works, but I remember being on a higher dosage because, I don't know, just be more effective. And I had really bad side effects. So we started off with, I don't remember the brand name of the birth control, but me and my twin actually got really depressed to the point where like we were so yawnery. Like
because
my dad's-
Because of birth control?
Yes.
So why would you-
Our hormones changed and we got really depressed. We got angry. We started losing appetite. There was just so many side effects that me and my twin were getting, and people in our family were telling us.
Did this happen right away though?
No, it happened after like a year. They started seeing a change in us. We were both on the same thing. We had the worst PMS when it came to our periods. It was like the worst week. Nobody could talk to us. It was really bad, guys. Like very bad.
You still have.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
No, not as bad, Bill. You will never understand because you've never experienced me on birth control.
I just wanted to say this. Before we say anything else, this is more of an educational thing. And if you're looking forward to getting on birth control, or if you're already on it and you're thinking of getting off of it, this is good. And if you're a dude, you can relate to me. Continue watching. Because Mariah, you know how much stuff you blamed on your birth control?
If I was to mess up and blame it on myself,
oh, it's because I have to poop. You know, it's like I need it. Why can't guys have something that we can blame?
But birth control is putting in like hormones in your body. Like it's all like a super hormone.
Yeah.
It's adding more like all this extra stuff, and it really changed me and Megan, and it was like really bad. All of our family members were like, you know, you guys are so like, you guys aren't as happy anymore. Like, I think you guys need to switch birth control brands, try something else. So we did switch over to a different birth control. Well, I was on something different and Megan stayed on the same one just because she didn't feel like she needed to, which she did. But I switched over and I tried this new one, and it was to help acne and I guess like dermatologist help. And guys, Mike, I will say the one advantage of being on birth control was I had clear skin.
Who knew that? Birth control can literally make your face clear up.
Yeah, Bill, it's literally like
give me some of that. I need some birth. Look at this. I got marks right here. Come on, I need some birth control myself. We need to make a guy version of birth control just so we can clear up our faces and we can, you know, but not the moody part. No. I want to avoid that.
All right, that's the worst part.
So I got on this birth control that helps with acne and my skin was so clear. Like, I missed that because recently my face is breaking out a little more frequent just because, you know, we're having our adult stresses and we're in a different stage in our lives, but...
She's stressed, though. That's why. It's not like, because of anything except stress.
I would get one pimple a year, and it wasn't even a pimple. It was like a red mark. That's how crazy
it
was.
Yeah, and she would freak out about having one pimple.
Yeah.
And I had like 30, remember?
Yeah. It was like, it was vice versa.
Yeah.
It was vice
versa. I had bad acne and you didn't.
But... I'm gonna get on to now the scary part of when I was on birth control.
What do you mean scary?
So, Yes, you were dating me then. Actually, you were dating me.
You said scary. What's scary?
You'll see. You know, remember why. Okay. So, this birth control that I was on had a lot of side effects where I was nauseous. I was always dizzy. I always felt like I was gonna pass out. My heart would be out of my chest. And I thought maybe it would go away after I adjusted to it. There was one day where I was about to go to work. I was working at Sweet Frog at the time. And I felt like I was going to pass out, and I had to call off work because I couldn't drive like that. I wasn't even being dramatic. Like, I literally, guys, felt like I was dying. My heart was racing. I never felt this type of feeling in my entire life, and I'm not even being dramatic when I say I felt like I was dying, because literally that weekend, a couple days later, I was still so sick. Do you remember when we were at
the lake house?
The lake house, and we were laying in bed, and I was like, babe, I'm like really dizzy.
No, you sat in the room with your friends while I was out there having fun.
I couldn't sleep because when I would go to sleep and rest my eyes, I felt like I was spinning. The room was spinning. It was like the scariest thing. I told Bill, I was like, if I'm not feeling better, you need to take me to the hospital tomorrow because I literally feel like I'm dying. And I feel like the birth control was legit killing me. And I know it might sound dramatic, but I'm not joking. This birth control brand that I was on, actually a lot of people have died from it.
Wait.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, why are you using it then? If it's literally like you've seen that people have died from it, I would be like, yeah, no, we're definitely not doing that.
No. Every birth control has different side effects and everybody reacts differently. The birth control I was on before, people have died from that. But it all depends on your body and how you react.
Everybody's body is different. Everyone reacts to it differently, and I had a bad reaction to it. Mm-hmm. And I got very sick, guys. Like, I was so sick, and everyone was telling me, and I actually had a friend who was on the same birth control pill as me and had the same exact side effects. And I know a lot of people in my family who have taken birth control have also had the same side effects. So I think it runs in our genes that we just don't work well with birth control. So I took that next step.
Which was?
Getting off birth control. I needed to see if that was the issue, because if there was something that was like internally wrong that I didn't know of, I needed to see what it was. So I stopped birth control.
And she's still off of it to this day. Yeah. It's been what, 2 years?
2 years. But I will say this. My first period back of not being on birth control was the worst period. I had to call off work. I have been experiencing the most excruciating cramps. It's been getting better, honestly, but I still, to this day, because of birth control, it has messed my period up so bad to the point where my period cramps, terrible.
I can contest to that because Mariah, I've never seen her in so much pain. She's never had to use a heating pad or anything on her periods. And if you don't know a lot about periods, literally it's terrible seeing someone go through it and you literally can't do anything about it except watch them just like huddle up on their bed or in the shower or whatever makes it feel better.
I would have him sit next to me and I would have to hold his hand.
When
and
you
like
go to bed,
it.
She couldn't fall asleep.
Yeah.
I'd be knocked, like snoring
and
next to her.
Yeah,
and she'd wake me up, I'd be like, what? And she like grab my arm like as hard as she could.
Everybody is different, and just because I have these side effects doesn't mean that you guys will. Honestly, if I was you, I would just try it. If you're looking to try it out, see how it is for a year, a couple months. Usually it takes about 6 months to have the side effects go away. You always have side effects when you first start.
Because you have to adjust.
Yeah, but I do recommend it, but if you have a sensitive body like me,
it's probably not worth it,
and I would just use that extra protection if you are sexually active or your periods, you know, you just suck it up.
So besides the side effects that come with it, it helped your acne. I think it made you happier at that time in the beginning.
Not in the beginning, it made me worse.
Okay, that's one of the cons.
Okay.
It made your face better. It protects you from pregnancy.
And it
helps your cramps, your period cramps.
Oh God, yeah.
The cons are there's a lot of side effects. And it could make you little pissy. A lot.
Yeah.
If you're the type of girl that she is. And then what? Without it?
I feel like I was dying when I was on
So now that you have without it, you have a higher risk of getting pregnant.
But.
Or already got pregnant. And then you had acne. A little bit. But that's okay. Come on. We love you for who you are. Your natural self is natural beauty. That's like finest.
Preach, babe. Preach. But
I'm gonna preach. I should be a freaking preacher. TEDx. Talk and make a talk show. Make a podcast. You can do it if you try. And if you try, you can do it. It's a revolving cycle. You set your mind to something, you're gonna accomplish it. See, I can do this, babe.
Okay. For anyone who is wondering, no, we are not trying to have kids right now. We do stay safe and we're protected.
You're just gonna throw a bombshell like that?
What?
I was hyping it up. Baby number one, she is not pregnant.
No, I am She's not pregnant. Pregnant. We are not trying yet.
But when are we?
After we're married.
That's the hope. I'm gonna tell you guys, I know you guys are so excited for us to have kids, to get married, and to move into our house. We're moving into our house. After that, I could start focusing on the pop and the question. And after that, then we want to start focusing on kids. Now, we don't know. Life throws freaking
different curveballs
at you. Look, we read each other's mind. Maybe we are telepathy, you know? Maybe we got, like, couple telepathy. A little couple telepathy. She's showing stuff in her face over here. But no, we are not trying to have kids yet right now. But she is off birth control. So there is a higher risk. It's like, if you're on birth control, 99.9% guaranteed you're not gonna have kids. With us, it's 100% chance if anything happens,
we're screwed.
You're screwed. So, I mean, not screwed in a bad
screwed.
Way.
Not screwed, like, I'd be excited. Honestly, I'd be so happy if we had a kid right now, but.
Would you really? I would love our kid if we had one.
I would be worried.
A little baby Marble running around.
What if we named our kid Marble?
Comment down below some baby names.
We'll name our kid Marble, and I don't think
Marble?
We can do that.
I would never, no, not
That's
Marble.
So embarrassing.
Maybe like his middle name Marble. What about like Sophia Marble Ritter?
I don't know.
Sophia is a cute name though, yeah.
That is a cute name.
I don't know
guys, we might have a girl, we might have a boy, you never know. But no, I'm not pregnant, no, we're not trying. If life takes us to where we're pregnant tomorrow, then we're pregnant tomorrow. But that's not, we're not trying for that.
And once again, this is not like like advice saying go out and get birth control or get off of birth control. Whatever works for your body, go for it. But I know if it was happening like it was happening to Mariah and it made her a different person, and
I just want to share my story. I want to tell you guys, you know, how it affected me, what happened with me, because I know so many girls go through the exact same thing as me. But it's also Bill's sisters who are on it, they don't have any side effects.
They're still
great.
On it, right?
Yeah,
my sister's 23, 24.
Wow.
She's like still on it, going strong.
And she had no side effects. Every single person's body is different. So it kind of just depends on you and how your body
works. You know what's funny? We can play this video back when we have kids in the future and like show them this. Like if we have like a baby girl, we can show them this.
No, that's going to actually be really weird looking back on these like videos.
Our kids are going to be watching our videos. Just like all of you. That is insane. Like you guys are getting it.
I feel like they'll cringe out watching us.
Our kids?
Yeah, I just feel like they'll be like, ew, mommy, daddy,
no.
You're gross.
They're going to think, I feel like they're going to think we're badass.
Maybe.
Mom got off of birth control, you know. We got skydiving clips.
Yeah.
We got everything in here. We got our Marble Squad to show them. We're gonna be like, hey, look at our Marble Squad. For all the boyfriends watching this, if this explains why your girlfriend has been like a little crabby recently, then boom. If she's not on birth control, then I don't know what's going
There's
on.
No
with
excuses.
Her.
No excuses.
Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. We wanted to sit down and do a little, you know, video like this because we haven't really talked like about pregnancy. I've done pregnancy pranks,
which we don't want to do that.
And you've done like pregnancy pranks on me.
Yeah, which.
But we never talked like straight about what our actual plans are with pregnancy. Mm-hmm. We've only talked about our house.
Yeah, that's it.
But stay tuned. We are only posting 3 times a week, which is gonna be awesome because we have some fire content coming your way. Challenge videos, maybe a little prank videos coming soon.
I don't know,
but they're gonna be awesome. And I really hope you guys enjoy everything that you are watching.
Yes. But yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video and we will see you guys in the next one. But until then, peace.
Oh, wait, before we leave, our merch is 20% off.
Oh, yeah.
We totally forgot to mention, guys, our merch is 20% off. Go in the link in the description, you will see our merch, JD Corp, and you can purchase a hoodie or a t-shirt.
Yes.
They're both 20%
off
today.
So go hop on that before they're sold out, and we will see you guys in the next video.
See you guys.
Peace. Love you guys.